Hello, welcome again. Continuing with the way 2016 of production and industrial engineering, starting with question number 31. A 1 meter into 10 mm into 10 mm cantilever beam is subjected to a uniformly distributed load per unit length of 100 newton per meter as shown in the figure below. The normal stress due to bending at 5 P is, so as the uniformly distributed load is 100 newton per meter, okay, and so at P the bending moment will be 100 into 1 square by 2, okay, so this is your bending moment at point P, okay. So from the bending equation, that is MA by I is equal to sigma by Y, and M is your 15 newton meter or 15 newton mm, 15,000 newton mm, and I is your, as cross section is your 10 into 10, so I is your 10 into 4, 10 to the power 4 by 12, okay, and Y is your 10 by 2, that is 5, so you can find out sigma. Sigma is your 300 MPa, okay. So this is the maximum bending stress at, or normal stress at point P. Next, a thin walled cylindrical pressure vessel of internal 2 meter is designed to withstand an internal pressure of 50 kPa gauge if the allowable normal stress at any point within the cylindrical portion of the vessel is 100 MPa. The minimum thickness of the plate of the vessel is, so here the internal diameter is your 2 meter, so D is your 2 meter, okay, and internal pressure is your 500 kPa, okay, so P is your 500 kPa, okay, so the hoop stress is PD by 2T, so this is your P is your 500 and D is your 200 mm and T is your T we have to find out, okay. So as this is the maximum stress in the thin walled vessel and this is circumferential stress, okay, and maximum stress is your 100 MPa, so this is equal to 100 MPa. So putting this equal to this quantity equal to that 100 into 10 to the power 3 kPa or 500 kPa, so we can get T as 500, answer is 500. Next, an engine connected with a flywheel is designed to operate at an angular speed of 800 rpm. During operation of the engine, the maximum change in kinetic energy in a cycle is found to be 6240 joules. In order to keep the fluctuation of angular speed within plus minus 1% of the average value, the moment of inertia in kilogram meter square of the flywheel should be. So here the mean speed is given as 800 rpm, okay, and fluctuation of speed is given as that given is 1%, okay. So the maximum speed will be 800 into 1.01 and minimum speed will be 800 into 0.9, okay, and the maximum change in kinetic energy is 6240, and the kinetic energy in case of flywheel is I omega square by 2. So when we put omega max, then we get maximum kinetic energy. When we put omega min, then we get minimum kinetic energy. And I we have to calculate. Okay. So omega max is in radian per second. Okay, according to that, you can calculate 2 pi n by 60, okay, and omega min is according to 792, so that will be 82.9, okay, and changing the energy is given, okay, now putting the value of omega max and omega min and chi changing chi, we can find out I is just 44.62 kilogram, okay. So answer is just 44.62 kilogram. Next, a 2 mm into 2 mm square opening in a vertical wall is covered with a metallic plate of same dimension as shown in the figure below. Consider the acceleration due to gravity to be 10 meters per second square. The force exerted by water on the plate is, so this is your plate, okay, and this the cross section is 2 meters, and height is this height above this plate is 2 meters, and total height is here, and from the bottom it is 4 meters. Okay, so we have to calculate the force exerted on the plate. Okay. If we draw a pressure diagram, the pressure at this surface will be 0, and at this surface, at the top of it, it will be rho g h1, and h1 will be 2 meters, and at the bottom surface of the plate, it will be rho g h2. Okay. So the average pressure, as the pressure variation is linear, it is rho g h1, and here it is rho g h2. Okay. So the, as the pressure variation is linear, so the average pressure acting here is will be the average of these two. Okay. So the average pressure will be rho g h1 plus rho g h2 by 2. Okay. And this is the pressure acting on the plate. It will multiply h1 plus h2 is your 4 plus 2. Okay. The h1 is 4. Sorry, h2 is 4, as h1 is your 2. And rho is 1000 and g is 10. So the average pressure into area is going to be the force factor of the plate, and area of the plate is 22, so that is 100 kilo. Okay. Next, the ideal gas of mass M is contained in a rigid tank of volume V at a pressure P. During a reversible process, its pressure reduces to P1. Following statements are made regarding the process. P, heat is transferred from the gas. Q, work done by the gas is zero. R, entropy of the gas remains constant. S, entropy of the gas decreases. Okay. So here the mass of the ideal gas is M. Okay, and it is contained in volume in a rigid tank of volume V, and the pressure is being reduced from P to P1. Okay, and the volume is constant. Okay, because it is a rigid tank and gas is contained in rigid tank. Okay, so from the ideal gas relationship, because gas is ideal, so P1 V1 by T1 is equal to P3 by T, as V is constant, so P1 by T1 is equal to P by T, as the pressure has been reduced. Okay, so as P1 is less than P, so T1 is also less than T. Okay. So temperature will decrease. Okay, now from the first law, from dQ is equal to dU plus dU, and as there is no change in volume, but it will be zero. Okay, so dQ is your at constant volume is mCV T1 minus T2. This T1 is less than T2, so this dQ is negative. So the heat is transferred from the gas. Okay, that is correct. It is transferred from the gas. Okay, so dQ is negative, so heat is transferred from the gas. Okay, and ideal to zero, the work done is zero. This statement is also the work done from the gas is zero. So P and Q are correct. So now we check R and S. Now, from the first to find out the entropy change, okay, from the first law we have this dQ is equal to W plus dT, and dU to dU, W plus dU, dividing by T, dQ by T, dU by T, dU by T, and dW by T, dW is 0, so this is 0, so dQ by T is equal to dU by T, so integrating we have this term as entropy, and dU by T as this, okay, so dU we can write mCV dT by T, so as this dt is your negative. Okay, so this is negative, so entropy will decrease. Okay, so answer is so. So the fourth statement also is your, because this S statement is also correct, so answer is your. Next. A long, slender metallic rod of length L is used as a pin as shown in the figure below. The left end of the pin is kept at a constant temperature, Tb. The pin loses heat by convection to the atmosphere, which is at a temperature TA. TA is less than TB. The four options of the temperature profile are shown. Identify the correct option. So this is your fin, this is base temperature, this is your atmospheric temperature, this is and heat is of by convection, and that length is N, and here is X is 0. Okay. So these are the four graphs. Okay. So so from the infinite long fin, the temperature distribution is given as this. T is equal to T minus TA, TB minus TA is equal to E rate for MX. Okay. Where M is your HP by KL. KA. Okay. So H is your convective coefficient, P is parameter, K is thermoconductivity, and A is area of cross section. Okay. And X is the length 0 to infinity. Okay. And T is the pressure, T is the base temperature, T is the temperature at distance X. Okay. So when X becomes infinity, T becomes equal to T. Okay. So it will never so to reach the temperature of the fin equal to TA, the length should be of infinite, it should be infinity. Okay. So from this graph, you can see this graph, the TA will never reach. Okay, and because infinite length will never reach. So option B is another graph, the TB is this line will strike, this line will meet the axis. Okay. And here the line will also meet the axis. Okay, here the line will also here. The line will be parallel to that x-axis, so it will not meet the x-axis. So the TA temperature will never reach because it is upper here in plane. Okay. So answer is with B. Next, a fully developed turbulent flow through a circular pipe, a head load of H1 is observed. The diameter of the pipe is increased by 10%, thus for the same flow rate and head load of H2 is noted. Okay. The diameter of the pipe is increased by 10% for the same flow rate and head load of H2 is noted. Assume friction factor for both the cases of pipe flow is same. Is the same. The ratio of H2 by H1 is closest to option A 0.34, option B 0.62, option C 0.87, and option D 1. Okay. We know that the head loss in terms of friction factor is your H is equal to F L B square by D to E. So F is your friction factor and L is the length of the pipe. Okay. And diameter of the pipe is increased by this is the first case. Okay. When the diameter is increased by 10%. Okay. So it means D is your 1.1 D. Okay. Or we can see, we can change this equation in further quantities, further in Q. So Q is your discharge, and that is equal to A into B, area into velocity. Okay, so we can change this velocity in terms of Q, and A is your area, pi by 4 d square. So your B will be Q by pi by 4 d square. So putting this value, we will have F L Q square divided by pi square by 4 square to D4. So H can be written as 4F L Q square pi square D by 2D. Okay. So we are when other because we are changing only the diameter of the pipe is increased by 10%. Only the diameter has been changed. So we will take the relationship of head with respect to diameter. So H is inversely proportional to D pi or H is actually proportional to D pi. So when suppose initially the diameter is D1, okay, so H1 is and head loss is H1 is 1 by D5 and H2 is 1 by D5, D2 5. Okay, so H1 by H2 is your D2 by D1 5. Okay, so that D2 by D1 ratio is your, so D1 by D2 ratio is your 1 by 1.1. So H2 by H1 is your 0.602. The answer is option B. Next, Two cast iron blocks P and Q, each of 500 mm length, have same cross section area. The block P has rectangular cross section of 100 mm into 200 mm. The block Q is of square cross section. Okay. Both P and Q were cast under the same conditions, with all their surfaces enclosed within the bolt. The solidification type of a casting is proportional to the scale of the ratio of its volume to its surface area. The ratio of solidification time of the block P to block Q is, okay. Now consider block P, and the length of block is 500 mm, and the block P is of the total cross section is 100 into 200 mm. Okay. So area of cross section of block P is 200 into 100, okay. And the perimeter will be 2 into 200 plus 100 or 600. Okay. Now we have perimeter. Okay. So we have 6 faces of the block. Okay. So the area of all the 6 faces will be that perimeter into length. Okay. Perimeter into length and 2 into AC, because each that perimeter will, that perimeter into length will contain 6 to 4 faces, and 2 faces will be, this is 2 AC. Okay. So the area of all the 6 faces will be this, or either we can calculate by this 2 into 200 into L, and 2 into 200, 2 into 100 into L, and then 2 into AC, okay, or 2 into 200 into 100. Okay. So we can calculate by either method. Okay, so this is the surface area. So surface area will be your 3400. Okay, 34, 4 times 0, mm. Yes, okay. And volume is your, we have 3 dimensions, 200, 100, and this is your volume, okay. Now, for block C, sorry, block Q, the area of cross section is, as the area of cross section for both the blocks are same, have the same cross section area. So area of cross section is same, that is 200 and 200. Okay, so this is your 200 and 200. Okay, and so one side is your 141.42. Okay, and so the perimeter will be 4 into this side. Okay, so this is your perimeter. Now again, calculating the surface area by same formula, that is perimeter into length plus 2 into this area. Okay, 141, or we can say this 200 into 100. Okay, so this is your, or this is your 322842. Okay, now the volume is your 200 into 100 into same volume. Okay, good length is same. Okay, now the given that the solidification time is directly proportional to B by A square. Okay, so TP is for the block P, TP will be B by A square, and for block Q, it will be PQ is equal to B by A for Q. Okay, so now dividing these two, as the volume is same, so we will cancel out, but area is different. So here it will be TP. AP is here in the bottom, and TQ above, AQ above. So this will be TP by TP is equal to AQ by AP. So putting the values of areas, this is your area 34000, and this is your area for Q. Okay, putting these values, we can get the ratio of time, that is 0.90. 155. Okay, so this is a blank type question. So answer is 0.90155. Okay, next. A 300 mm long copper wire of uniform cross section is pulled in tension so that a maximum tensile stress of 270 MPa is built within the wire. The entire deformation of the wire remains linearly elastic. The elastic modulus of the copper is 100 GPa. The resultant elongation will be in MM per minute. So this is very, very simple question, because stress is given, E is given. So stress by E is your strain, and length is given. Okay, and the length is given, 300 mm. So strain into length is your strain in length. Okay, so this is very, very simple. Stress by E strain, and then multiply by L. Okay, so answer is 0.81. Next, in a single pass rolling operation, a 200 mm wide metallic strip is rolled from a thickness 10 mm to a thickness 6 mm. The roll radius is 100 mm and it rotates at 200 rpm. The roll strip contact length is a function of roll radius and initial and final thickness of the strip. If the average flow stress in the plane strain of the strip material in the roll gap is 500 fp, the roll subtracting force in kilonewton is. Okay. So this is the plane strain case analysis without hydrogenic reaction. Okay, so here the roll pressure is of 500 MPa, so that is the average flow stress also. Okay, so average flow stress is equal to roll pressure. Okay. So this is your 500 MPa. Okay, now this is your stress, or we can say pressure. Now this pressure will be acting on the strip, and we have to calculate the area of the strip at which this pressure is acting. So this can be written by projected length into width. Okay, and the length of the projected length is given by R into root H, root. Okay, so R is radius of roller, and H del H is change in thickness. Radius of roller is your 100 mm. Roll radius is 100 mm, and change in thickness is 10 mm minus 6 mm. Okay, so this is 4 mm. So this is your length or contact length of the strip. Okay, and width of the strip is your 20 mm. Okay, width of the strip is 100 mm, and this is your LP comes out as 20 mm. So area of the strip, this pressure is acting is 20 into 200. Okay, so that is the separating force. P into that width of strip into length of strip is your separating force, that comes out as 2000 kilo, sorry, Newton, not 2000 kilometers. So answer is your 2000 kilometers. Next, two solid cylinders of equal diameter have different heights. They are compressed plastically by a pair of rigid dies to create same percentage reduction in their respective heights. Consider that the die workpiece interface friction is negligible. The ratio of final diameter to the total cylinder, the ratio of the final diameter of the total cylinder to that of longer cylinder is, so the this is your A cylinder, okay, and diameter D, and it is compressed to final diameter DFA, okay, and height, initially the height is HA, and the final height is HFA, okay, and this is B, and its diameter is same as this diameter, okay. And its final diameter is DFB, and this height is slightly shorter than this. Okay. So this is okay. So as the percentage reduction is same. As the percentage reduction in height is same, okay, so the change, the ratio of the initial height to final height for both will be same. So this is the HA is the initial height for A, and HFA is the final height for A, and this is initial height for B, and this is point light for B. Okay, so and the as it is the case of plastic deformation, so initial volume of both block or cylinder remains same. So initial volume, volume of the block of both the block will remain same. So this is initial volume will be the final volume. So this is your initial volume 5 by 4 d scale h a, and this is your final volume for block a, y by 4 d f scale by h f a. So from this h a by h f a is your d scale by d f a d scale h a. Okay. Similarly, we can find out for b also. Okay. So h b by h f b is your d scale by d scale f b. Okay. So now, given that the percentage reduction for both the block is same, so HF, so HA by HFA is equal to HB by HFB. Okay, so this is your B square by B square FA, and this is your B square by B FB square. Okay, as initial diameter same, so BFA is equal to BFB. So BFA is equal to BFB. So answer is the 1. Okay, so just you have to create the initial volume and equal to final volume, and for this block P is B also. Okay, and then you have to calculate the height ratio and then diameter ratio. Okay. Initial to final height, so initial final height for A is 100, B, and this is same. Evaluating this equal, we get 1. Next. Two flat steel, each of 25 mm thickness, are being resistance port welded using a current of 600 ampere and weld time of 0.2 seconds. The contact resistance at the interface between two sheets is 200 micro ohm. And the specific energy to melt the steel is 10 into 10 to the power 9 joules per meter cube. The spherical melt pool of diameter 4 mm is formed at the interface due to current flow. Consider the electric energy is completely converted into thermal energy, the ratio of heat used for melting to the total resistive heat generated is okay. So here the current is 600 ampere, okay, and the distance is 200 micron, okay, and time is 0.2. Okay, so the heat generated in this time is I scale R. Okay, so the heat generated is 14402. Okay, and heat generated and the specific energy to melt the steel is this. Okay, and area of that magic or spherical melt pool is your area of the spherical, okay, 4 pi 3 pi r. Okay, so sorry, this is the volume of the spherical melt pool, because it is a spherical shape, so this is the volume of the spherical melt pool. Okay, and this is the specific energy to melt seed. So the total energy is multiplication of these two. Okay, so this will be 334.93 joules. Okay, so heat generated is this. Now heat used to cause melting is your this, and heat available is this. Okay, so answer is your ratio of these two is 0.3232. Okay. Next, a cylindrical bar of 100 mm diameter is orthogonally straight turned with cutting velocity, speed, and depth of cut of 120 meter per minute, 0.25 mm revolution. Mm per revolution and 4 mm respectively. The specific cutting energy of the work material is 1 into 10 to the power 9 joule per meter cube neglect the contribution of field force towards cutting power. The main tangential cutting force is in kilonewton, in newton is we know that a specific cutting energy is your power consumed by in cutting driver metal removal, and power consumed in cutting is your fc to b, and metal removal is your velocity into depth of cut into p. Okay, so this is your mr. So from this b we cancel out, so we will have fc divided by d into f. Okay, and u is given as 1 into 10 to the power 9. Okay, and f is your 0.25 mm per revolution. Okay, so this is your 0.03025 meter per revolution, and d is your 4 mm. Okay, from this we can calculate f, because only unknown quantity is your fc. Okay, so fc can get. So what we have to remember, that we have to remember that that basic thing, that specific cutting the range of power consumption cutting where the MR and power consumption cutting your FC to B, and MR is your velocity into B, the to cut into your P. Next, so we will solve the remaining question in the next video.